Hi, this is Serdar Yegulalp for InfoWorld at IDG. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to install a new version of Python side by side with an existing old one, and ensure that the two don't conflict. This system already has Python 3.7 installed on it. Python 3.8 has been out for some time now, and so I'd like to install it and run it side by side with the existing version, but I don't want the two of them to conflict. So here's how we're going to make that work. When you start the installer for the new version, the options on the first page should be left more or less as is. The one option you should not select, Add Python to Path. If you do this for the new version of Python that you're installing, it will supersede the old one. It won't overwrite it completely, but the new version will be recognized in lieu of the old one all the time. And if that's not what you want, then that's going to be a problem. So for the next step, click Customize Installation. All of these options should also be left as is. The one you definitely want to leave alone is the one labeled PyLauncher. This is installed separately, and so it can't be removed here anyway. It was installed in a previous version of Python, so we're going to keep it as is. We don't have a choice. In the next step, customize the install location to something a little easier to reach than this very deep level of directories. I prefer to place it right off the root drive. All of these other options can also be left as is. Click Install, and you'll start the setup process. Once the setup process is finished, you can close on onto the Python installer. Now to test your new installation, first launch the terminal. Instead of Python, type py instead. The PyLauncher, as this program is called, is a small program installed on the Windows version of Python that allows you to launch any of the existing versions of Python available on that system. By default, it's launching the most recent version, Python 3.8.1. But if we simply pass a command line argument, we can launch Python 3.7. You can also see which versions are available by typing -0 as a command line argument. And finally, when you want to run Python programs as you normally would, you simply invoke the version that you want, and then pass any command line parameters that you would normally use to run the program. If you have questions, please add a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And if you like this video, please hit the like and share buttons. For more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.